Welcome back to Gate Baba. In this lecture, I will be discussing another electrode designation. In previous session, I have discussed BIS designation, that means Bureau of Indian Standard designation, that is only used in India. When it comes to international, another standard designation available based on ISO. I think all of you know about ISO, International Organization for Standardization. So based on ISO, there is a special designation for electrode, and that follows ER4312HJX. The first letter indicates which type of process is used to produce the electrode. Here E means extrusion, as usually same as BIS designation. Okay, and the second letter indicates the type of flux used. If that is replaced with A, and that is acidic flux. If B is used, basic flux, and C is used, cellulose flux. If R is used, that is rutile flux is used. That means the covering of the electrode. Okay, and come to the next two letters. These two are joined. Okay, and those will represent the mechanical properties of joint. And the first four indicates the yield strength and ultimate strength of the joint, and the three indicates the percentage elongation as usually in BIS. And the second set of two letters indicates the performance characteristics of coverings. So what are the coverings indicates? If there is a one, then that is in, then that indicates the welding position, and if there is two, that indicates the welding current and voltage settings. Okay, so these are the also two standard quantities, and these three set of letters. There may be one letter or two letter or three letters based on our requirement. I am giving the three letters here. Sometimes two letters or one letter may be there. Okay, and those three letters indicate some special purposes. Those are, if H is there, then hydrogen controlled electrode. If J is there, that is iron powder electrode. If X is there, that is radiographic quality of weld. Okay, these are the designation based on ISO, International Organization for Standardization. Okay, this thing also you have to know. Until now, there is no question asked about the designation, whether it is a BIS or it is a ISO. But just for the information, I am giving you. Maybe this year or next year, this question may come. But at least you should know this because of ISRO exam. ISRO always try to ask questions on new concepts like this. Okay. That's why be ready with each and every concept, then we can answer any question, any theoretical question or problematic question. Okay, and that's it. Thank you.